what's up, Mzansi? It's your favorite neighborhood stylist, Kat Godana, and you're tuned in to MBA Live. Today, we're diving into the MBA scene, soaking up all things lifestyle and, of course, the ball culture.
And I am Pumelelo Frypan. Some call me the mayor. We're here to ensemble a squad of forward-thinking and like-minded ballers. So if you're about exploring the beautiful game, the culture, the lifestyle beyond, you're at the right place. Because here on NBA Live, it's everyone's game.
Of course. And this past Friday was International Women's Day, the day that we celebrate our women's achievements in society and the culture. And in line with this, we have a powerhouse, uAsanda Nxumalo, in the building. And I'm excited to hear what she has to say about basketball culture.
And on today's School You on the Game, we focus on African sensation, Nneka Ogwamike.
And for today's NBA Style segment, I'm styling uAsanda for a girls brunch, the NBA way.
And you already know, we've got an interview and exclusive musical performance with rising talent, Kiamo. You don't want to miss these sonics and vocals, so stay tuned right to the end.
So stay in the loop, don't sleep on the conversation. Hit us up on our socials using the hashtag MBA Live. But for now, let's kick things off with our special guest, uAsanda Nxumalo.
Yebo, and on our white couch today, we have a special guest, an amazing dancer all the way from the south side of Johannesburg. Some know her as Nessa, but today I'm going to introduce her with a government name, uAsanda Nxumalo. How are you doing, ma'am?
Oh, good. How are you?
All good. All good. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling great. Thank you.
All good. Tell me this. I know you're an amazing dancer. How did that start? Especially in Soweto. That's where you grew up, right?
Yeah.
Tell me about it.
So Soweto Vele, you know, it's the township for Jaiva, right?
For sure. Mm-hmm.
So I was born in Soweto. I grew up in Soweto. And ironically, the first place where I learned how to dance was from a group called Soweto's Finest. And they were still based in the south at the time.
Yes.
Now they've moved to Newtown and they're much bigger.
That's right.
So they basically take kids and teach them how to dance and put them in, you know, industry spaces, mm-hmm. and introduce them to the dance culture.
For sure.
But more so like being professionals with style asasekazi,
yeah.
you know, like authenticity and stuff like that, which is what you don't see. Most people, when they market dance, it's usually like something from that's westernized,
yes.
in a term of, okay, your ballet, your, you know, but it's not most often where you find your street style being marketed that way. And
it's
those were the people that put me on, mm-hmm. in that sense, you know.
For sure.
So yeah, ever since I was like 11, I've been rocking this thing.
You started young, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I love it because I see a resurgence of that culture, especially with young girls going at it. I mean, just last weekend, I was in a street dance battle, a contest, something of that sort. And every weekend in Newtown, I see a lot of young girls coming in for those dance classes. You host one of those, right?
Yes, yes.
Tell me about it.
So basically, kids just come and learn how to dance. It's just a fun incentive for them. But recently, it's, you know, it's been a space where a lot of young girls,
yes.
have been able to show up in such spaces and also learn, but not only learn, but teach at such a young age as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because I also started teaching people how to dance at the age of 12. So it's like
Amazing. It's very
beautiful to see that people who are coming into the space where I learned how to dance are also coming to learn how to dance and are leaving with this thing of, you know, I know so much now and I can do so much in this industry and I'm just a child.
Yes.
You know, more so I'm just a girl child. So I think that's the dope part about that space.
I love it, man. It's like each one teach one. I love the sisterhood
yeah, yeah.
there.
So speaking of spaces, I know I've been on sets with you with some of the biggest musicians in this country. I want to ask you, what is your advice to young women that are joining the entertainment industry?
As women, you often feel we are in that nature. We often try to please
nurture.
People and nurture and be the kindest person in the room. But it's very important to stand ground and remember what you are here for.
So as much as we do the teamwork, don't forget what you stand for.
Yeah, exactly.
As an individual.
Exactly.
I love that. And bringing it back to the courts, do you have any favorite basketball players?
Definitely, I do. Interestingly, my favorite basketball player right now, she used to be a rapper and a dancer, but now she's still doing the same actually in court because she's been going viral on TikTok and stuff. But Flo J. Johnson, she plays for the LSU Tigers. I hope she gets drafted in the WNBA one day because she is that great.
Not for sure, she's
great. But yeah, she's really dope. She's really dope.
thank you for joining us, Asanda. It's been lovely watching you grow, and I hope you continue to take young women on the journey with you as well. But for now, guys, let's check out the highlights from last week.
Except ballers, ready to dive into the latest slam dunking 3-point swishing action from week 19 of the 2023-2024 season? Well, strap in and let's see what's cooking on the court. Denver Nuggets versus Sacramento Kings saw the Nuggets win 117-96. Jamal Murray scored 32 points and Nikola Jokic got a triple-double with 14 points, 14 rebounds and 11 assists. The Spurs were straight up balling on Friday night, taking down the Thunder 132-118 victory. Spurs duo Victor Wembanyama and Devin Vassell had 56 points and 24 rebounds combined. But hold up, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander wasn't backing down for Thunder, leading the charge with 31 points of his own. Giannis was an absolute beast on Saturday. He dropped a jaw-dropping 46 points on Saturday, snatching 16 rebounds to lead the Bucks to 113-97 victory over the Bulls. With this win, Giannis now holds the most franchise wins by a player with 489 wins. King James became the first player in the NBA to reach 40,000 career points, beating the record he set last year when he beat Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's previous record of 38,387. Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum were on fire, dropping buckets. The Celtics brought their A game, ending the game with a 140-88 win over the Warriors, winning by 52 points. And there you have it, the lowdown on all the Week 19 highlights. Keep your eyes glued to NBA.com so you don't miss a beat of the action in the league.
And just like that, guys, it's time for an ad break. In true NBA tradition, you know we have to get the energy levels up. Yes, sir. So drop and give me 20. But if that's not your thing, kokumoya siyabuya njengamanje.
Yes, sir. We're riding this wave and keeping the vibe rolling. So join us on the conversation by using our hashtag NBA Life. After the break, we're tipping things off with School You on the Game. We'll get schooled on Neka Ogwemike and gain insight into her impressive basketball journey and contribution to the sports. Oh, and don't forget, download the NBA app to stay in the loop. Right now, let's catch you on the flip side.
Yo, what's up? We're back at it with NBA Life, the spot where we unpack the basketball culture, the lifestyle, and of course, the game.
That's right. We know that this show is more than just about the game. So right now, we're going to zone in into the School You on the Game segment just to level up your hoop IQ. Are you ready? You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Class is officially in session. Kung, 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 kung. On today's School You on the Game segment, we celebrate International Women's Day. Let's focus on Neka Ogwemike, who was selected number one in the overall 2012 WNBA's draft. Not only that, in the same year, she was Rookie of the Year. Fast forward to 2016, she is the most valuable player in the WNBA and of course, WNBA champion. She's also 8-time WNBA All-Star, and I'm not even done.
Yeah, keep going.
In the offseason, she signed with Seattle Storm. She's also the current president of the Women's National Basketball Players Association, and she is one of 25 WNBA greatest players of all time.
That's crazy.
Man, she's done it all and is still at it. And in honor of International Women's Day, let's check out Neka's career-defining moments in the WNBA.
In the league, a lot of headaches this season.
Well, a glaring thing that LA was lacking areas rebounding. -3, that was 11th in the WNBA in rebound margin. You got to improve in the rebounding if you want to compete in the WNBA. You're going to get that with Neka Ogwemike.
Born in Texas to Nigerian parents, Neka is one of four sisters, three of whom have been drafted in the WNBA. She and her sister Shanae were the first sisters to be drafted at number one in the WNBA. Neka played for the Los Angeles Sparks throughout her 12-year career period, same team in which the first African woman in the WNBA, Mwadi Mabi, Mbika from the DRC played for during their back-to-back championships in the early 2000s.
Who makes me tired, and she certainly does that all the time.
She made a lot of players tired in college, that's for sure, because she never stops working. And the thing that you want in a top pick and a WNBA draft pick is a player that is high energy, and that's exactly what you get from NECA. And
how? Oh, for sure. She's one of the most decorated players in the WNBA. Now check this out. She played a huge role in the negotiations of the Collective Bargaining Agreement, better known as the CBA. And in 2020, that resulted in an increase in salaries and travel benefits for all players in the WNBA. Now we stand a queen that stands on business on and off the court.
No! Agumake denied another chance. It's good! NECA Agumake puts it home. LA with a one-point lead. Whalen is going to have to heave. She does! That's it! Your 2016 WNBA champions.
Oh yeah, NECA Agumake will definitely go down as one of the most popular and decorated sports players in history, simply because her influence goes way beyond the basketball court.
And now that we've dropped some knowledge on you, let's head over to Word on the Street to hear about some of your favorite buzzer beater moments.
And next week, we want to hear who your favorite rookie of the season is so far. So join the conversation and use our hashtag NBA Live. So yeah, hit us up, whether you send us a video, whether you send us a picture or text. Your thoughts might get you a spotlight right here. Let's hear what you have to say.
Hey yo, what's up? My name is Shalom, and this season, my favorite buzzer beater has to be Dame Time. I'm a Milwaukee Bucks fan, and so watching Damian Lillard get that overtime buzzer beater against the Kings has to be one of the best parts of the season for me. Let's go, Bucks!
3 seconds, Dame pulls for the win!
Yo, Kat, talking about rookie of the season, do you know who's my favorite right now? Scoot Henderson of the Trailblazers.
Yeah.
I mean, he's picking up the pace right now, and I'm interested to see how the rest of the season is going to look like for him.
I mean, my boy Scoot is so dope. But you know who's really doing it for me right now?
Who is it?
My favorite rookie of the season is Victor Wembanyama. That man is on fire,
now,
Frypan.
He's on it. He's on it. I'll give you that. Now, let's check out this week's NBA On The Ground feature, where we get to hear from WNBA players who paved the way and made significant contribution to the game.
Mwadi Mabika, originally from the Congo.
Being the first African player to be in the WNBA and also to win the title was amazing.
Los Angeles Sparks are back-to-back WNBA champions.
Seeing how there are more opportunities slowly coming up with women finding the straighter path to success with education and sports. I won't say sports and education because our path was rough. We still made it to the W, playing with no shoes, playing under any kind of weather, no gyms or whatever. But seeing these girls have the opportunity to have a straighter path to success is beautiful to see.
Most importantly is the opportunity to give back to youth, as I was one of those that were privileged to have a career based on sports. So it's an opportunity to share my knowledge, to build confidence, and to be an example that Africans, when given an opportunity, can also succeed.
Knowledge that's kept is not really knowledge, and it's our duty to pass on the torch, and slowly, no matter how busy we are, we have to do it. It's encouraging. We need more, and we're gonna keep giving but advocating so that women have equal opportunity than the men on the continent, because if they do, there is nothing that they can do.
Demonstrate to youth that there is more beyond whatever life they're facing right now, as long as they dedicate themselves to school and to sports. Having that for women, most importantly, I think it serves as a great example to inspire those who have no faces or voices, whatever they are. So I appreciate the ability to be on television for those girls, because they need to see more of other successful people grinding for the future.
Yo, it's really inspiring to see how women keep on shaping the landscape of basketball for the future.
Indeed, it is. And this is more than just about hoops, guys. It's a lifestyle. And today, we have a young lady making her own moves in the music space. We have Kiamu in the building. And I'm excited how she sets it on fire with her latest single, Falling. Hey, Kiamu.
Hi.
So tell us, where are you from? Tell us a bit on your journey on music. Like, how did you grow up?
So I was born and raised in Joburg in the East. And I really grew up with a lot of instruments at home. My parents are both really into music. And so, you know, it was kind of evident, or rather imminent that I would be a musician, you know?
Yes.
And I started really, really early, you know, playing piano. And so my parents were like, oh my gosh, this child seems very, very interested in, you know, playing keys. And I taught myself a lot of it, you know, and then I did extra lessons and I did music in high school. And in high school, I actually studied classical voice.
Wow.
So we were doing lots of Mozart and Beethoven and, you know, and like arias.
Okay.
And then I was really a big fan of like medical shows. And so I then wanted to do medicine.
And how did that go?
It didn't go very well.
So you were just destined to be in this space.
I was very much destined to be in this space for sure.
Yo, Kat, we're chilling with a professional musician out here.
Period.
You've been doing it all your life. But something you've been doing as well is team sports.
Yeah.
You went to an all-girls school and you played sports with other women, young women at that time. What did that do for you?
I think it really solidified my idea of sisterhood, you know.
Yes.
Even off the field, we really had each other's backs. So we had each other's backs on the field and we had each other's backs even off the field, you know. And I think that is a beautiful way to live your life, knowing that you always have people on your back.
I love it. Now let's get down to the business of today. Your latest single, Falling.
Mm.
Who's falling here? Are you falling? Is someone falling for you? Or are you asking for a friend? What's happening there?
I'm definitely falling. I've been falling for a while.
Okay.
And I think that what's interesting about the song is that, or rather what's sad about it is that, you know, you can fall for anyone, but it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to fall back for you. And it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to catch you, you know?
Hey.
But we fall anyway, because falling is such a beautiful concept.
For sure. For sure. I love it. We can all related home somewhere somehow, right?
Yes, sir.
And that is so dope, Kiamu. I can't wait to see your performance for Falling.
Me too. Can't wait for you to hear it.
Shout out to the sisterhood. And just like that, we're off to a break. When we come back, we kick things off with Kat's NPA style segment, where she'll be styling the one and only Asanda Nxumalo for Girls Brunch. And don't dip, because we wrap up the show with a live performance by Kiamu. It's gonna be lit. See you on the flip side.
Sharding Tangumzanzi, welcome back to NBA Live. Here it's all about the lifestyle, the culture, and of course, the game.
That's right. You know I'm about that life as well. But without wasting any more time, let's head over to the Mbatlers with the style segment.
Get it.
Let's go.
On today's NBA style, we're taking Asanda on a girls' brunch date. And for our base, we have the Allen Iverson Hardwood Classic jersey, paired with some sunglasses to match the colors on the jersey. You know we stay coordinating over here. And then we have some shorts. Like I said, this outfit is dance friendly and we are working with a dancer. We wanted to be free. We wanted to be able to interact with her friends nicely. I accessorized the look with gold stacked necklaces paired with one gold cuff. And we finished off our look with classic low-cut sneakers. How are you feeling, girl?
I feel very stylish. I feel like I'm ready to dance when I get up off of that brunch table, you know? Yeah.
For sure. And there you have it, guys. Asanda with our girls' brunch look. I mean, I would kill this look myself. And if you'd like to cop this jersey, you can get yours at the closest NBA stores at Sandton City, Gateway Mall, or V&A Waterfront in Cape Town.
That's right. Yo, I know where I'm going right after the show. But for now, let's fast forward things and go check out the upcoming games in the league.
Yes, sir.
What's good, ballers? Week 21 is about to get lit with some spicy matchups. Get hyped for the hottest showdowns coming your way. On Monday, the 11th of March, the LA Lakers clash with the Minnesota Timberwolves. On Tuesday, the 12th of March, the Chicago Bulls lock horns with the Dallas Mavericks.
Wednesday, the 13th of March, Oklahoma City Thunder face off against the Indiana Pacers. On Thursday, the 14th of March, the Denver Nuggets meet the Miami Heat. On Friday, the 15th of March, the Milwaukee Bucks take on the Philadelphia 76ers. On Saturday, the 16th of March, Orlando Magic collide with the Toronto Raptors. On Sunday, the 17th, the Sacramento Kings and the New York Knicks close the week with a hot matchup. Don't miss the action. Download the NBA app and check out the complete game schedule. Let's go. All right, ballers. We've reached the end of this amazing episode.
So brace yourselves because Kiamu is about to perform her latest single, Falling.
That's it. Kat and I are officially signing out. So tune in next Sunday. Same place, same time, same good vibes and everything basketball related over here. But before you leave, download the NBA app to stay in the loop and join the conversation using the hashtag NBA Live. Because right here, it's everyone's game.
Kiamu, let's do it for the sisters. Hit it, girl.
That's right. Let's go.
You've got that brown skin, yeah, and those pretty little locks. Your aura is an ocean. You smell my oxytocin. Feels like the stars had me woven. Somehow I wasn't chosen. But keep your mind open, or is your heart frozen? I'm falling for you, and in my mind it is enough. I've never felt such deep a crush. I'm falling for you. All of the silence is a crutch, 'cause it would never be, never be just us. Never be just us. Never be just us. Never be just us. Never. Marveled and perplexed, my heart's in a shock. Falling and giggling, I'm tearing apart. Daydreams and low self-esteem held me down. Traces of you I'm not found. I'm dying, slowly disappearing into pieces. It's a science, loving and being lost, living like love. It would never be, never be. Never be. Never, no, never be. Never be, never be. Never be, never be. They don't be, they don't be, they don't never be just us.
Don't forget to join the conversation using the hashtag NBA Live. Your voice matters. Tune in again next week for the freshest vibes on NBA Live. We will be chatting with Pretty Audi, and we're also keeping things hot with an exclusive live performance by the man himself performing his track, Botso Botso. We'll be right back.
Thank you.